Hi everyone, this is Satish Kumar, application engineer here at Aegis India. So in this presentation, I'm going to take you through about how to create stunning technical documentation from 3D CAD data. So the agenda for this presentation is introduction about SOLIDWORKS Composer, and with implementing this technology, how efficiently you can do your technical documentation process faster than ever. And also we'll share some of the sample outputs which we've done previously. And we also share one of our customer case studies, so who gets benefits by implementing this technology for their technical documentation process. And also we'll end up with summary. So if at all you have a questions like what happens if the customers cannot understand the process, what happens if the customer speaks another language, what happens if the customer receives documentation that doesn't match the model, then this presentation will be the answer for these questions. So SOLIDWORKS Composer is a tool that allows non-CAD users to repurpose 3D CAD data to create 2D and 3D contents for technical communications, such as assembly instructions, product manuals, marketing collaterals, and training materials. So you can also implement this technology for across the company. So it is not only going to be helpful for a specific department in an organization, so it will be helpful for all the different departments. So the sales team can utilize these contents to promote their product to market. The assembly team can utilize this to find the assembling and dismantling procedure of specific product, step-by-step instructions. And the after sales team can utilize this to create service instructions, replacing component manuals, everything. So the basic workflow of this specific source is you need a 3D CAD data to import it inside this source, and where you can do a leverage of the creation of images, illustrations, movies, interactive contents, and web contents as well. So whenever there is a design change, you don't want to worry about it. You can access the latest file from your design team. Simply update the file with your older file in the Composer. So all the animations and the contents which you created will remain same. The CAD geometry will only gets updated. So let me show you the user interface of this platform. So this is the user interface of SOLIDWORKS Composer. So where you can open the multiple CAD files as an input. So it is not only needs to be a SOLIDWORKS file, it may be a STEP IGS, or it may be a PTC files other than that. So for an example, I'll open one of the gearbox assembly. So you can see that in the display, so you can get access to your 3D CAD files inside this viewport. So where you can also make changes to the background, and also if at all you want to make any changes in the shadows, grounds, illustrations, everything. So if at all you want to make any changes to a specific component colors, that also will be possible over here. So it allows you to create animations and other contents with the ease of use tools. So for an example, I need to create a sample animation of removing this specific part from the original position to the destination position. So I can simply move this components from one place to another place with some respective timing. So at the moment when I make changes the position from one location to another location, it create as an animation for my viewport. So you can see there is an animation which is created for my model over here. And also I can access to specific illustration contents like adding arrows and images, text inside this viewport to give it even more better understanding. That is also possible. You can do customize the authors, like changing the colors, make it as a gradient, so everything is possible. And also if at all you want to make it capture as a silhouette style, or it may be a flat wireframe style, you can also make changes to these different modes of publications whenever you need it. So at a moment when after I capture these kind of contents, I can also save it as static images. So these are all some of the static images which I captured previously. So where you can showcase the internal components, internal regions, and the section views, and also as well as the exploded views along with the bill of material. So everything you can able to highlight it over here. And apart from this, in the animation area, if at all you want to highlight any specific regions or any specific points, you can also use this digger to explain it even more better. You can adjust the size of the detail, and also you can make changes to the assembly region where you want to highlight even more clear than ever. So these are all some of the interactive tools which allows you to make your documentation process even more faster than ever. So once after done this, you can also save this entire things as animations, and also you can publish it as a web contents so that you can easily collaborate it with your suppliers and vendors. So this is one of the sample animation which we created for this specific gearbox. So with the help of this, you can create many deliverables for your technical documentation. So it may be illustrations, product manuals, assembly instructions, marketing materials, sales tools, installation instructions, everything you can able to get it from a single source of platform. So the key highlights of the technical documentation team, what they will prepare in their day-to-day life is some animations and interactive contents, and also create some operational procedures, part list catalogs, and also nowadays a lot of companies is creating digital web contents and also some technical publications. So let me show you some of the examples which we done previously. So this is one of the machine working functionality video. So once the CAD geometry is ready, you can start documentation sooner, earlier in your design stage. So where you can have access to make transparent your model, where you can add any context if you want to highlight in between the animations, and also if you want to detail any specific regions or any specific mechanisms you want to highlight, you can also make it with the help of detail views to make it even more clear to the person who is viewing this file. So, and apart from this, you can also highlight the complete set of working mechanism through animations. So this single video will explain the step-by-step procedure of how this machine will works. So the proper working functionality and the working principle is perfectly explained with the help of animation. So instead of explaining it through hand sketches or maybe any drawings, any static images, this kind of interactive videos will make them clear about your product and its functionalities. So, and apart from this, if at all we are having any huge product which contains many sub assemblies, many sub components, so you can also make it as some interactive contents. So in this C scooter, I need to give an instruction to remove the battery. So I can also create some thumbnails over in the right side, and also I can provide a step-by-step instruction buttons over here to give it interactive to the user who is viewing this file. So when they select the step-by-step procedure, so it will appropriately make doing the animation in your viewport. So this is how the user can interactively access their parts catalog. So even if at all they need to see the bill of material of this entire specific assembly, they can also get access to this bill of material. So where they can also get a cross highlighting between their BOM and their viewport. If at all they select any component, that also will get automatically highlighted in their bill of material. So, and apart from this, if at all you're handling any large assemblies, so it doesn't also limited to any specific kind of small assemblies. It also capable of creating instructions for large assemblies. So in this entire complete layout, I need to specify some instruction, like if some component is getting defective in the manufacturing, it needs to be rejected and place it over to the scrap. So I can clearly explain it with the help of visual representation. So if this component is getting defected, I need to take this component and put it in this scrap box. So and the actuations of robots and the real-time functionalities of any kind of automation projects, those also you can clearly explain it with the help of this visual representations. So, and apart from this, nowadays a lot of companies is moving on to the digital trends. They are trying to create some configurators to make their customers feel the experience of the product what they want. So in this bicycle, you can see there is a lot of different variations which the customer expects. Maybe some customer is expecting some different frame colors. So what we can able to do is we can make it configured to the different variations which we are providing to the customer end. So the customer can interactively choose the different colors for frame and the four color, if at all I need it in yellow or red, or I need it in black. So at a moment when they select the color, it will instantly get highlighted to my viewport, so that they can interactively choose the product which they want whenever they need it. So you can also able to publish this contents to your websites. The customer will also have the leverage to handle all these interactive contents in your websites. So apart from this, you may have a question, is composer is only capable of creating animations and static images? So exactly not. So you can also do some other standard manuals. So I can also show you one of the example. So this is one of the bench grinder operator guide. So in this guide, whatever images you are seeing in this document, so that images is getting out from the composer. So once after you get the CAD model, you can create the static images as well from your animations. So you can also generate some kind of video set. So it is not only capable of publishing it as a composer file or maybe a HTML file. You can also publish this entire animation as a MP4, simple MP4 video formats. So it's easily collaborable to your other ones who is on different locations. You can simply share it through email or WhatsApp, everything. So this is how you can generate a different outputs from this single platform. So even I can also show you some of the other sample outputs. So is it capable of only generating the videos? Exactly not. So you can also generate static images of your files. So if at all you need to highlight any specific parts to your other end suppliers or maybe a person, so you can also highlight this specific images. Even you can also make it as a vectorized images with all the relevant links, so from where it is dismantled, the pathway of the assembly, everything you can able to create it as like this images what you seen on the screen. So apart from this, you can also publish a HTML document, so which is also be able to publish in your websites. So now I'm opening one of the sample of the torsional frame assembly. So it can be opened with any browser. So a person needs to have a browser in his system, so he can open this file in any browser. So when he simply drag around the bill of material, it will highlight you the component in the viewport. Vice versa, if you hover over the component, it will also highlight you in the bill of material. So these kind of digital parts catalog will be helpful to make understand about your parts and components available in your assembly to all who is viewing your products in your websites. So to summarize this, the visual assets for your any kind of products is always make ready at the earlier stage of your process, and also you can do improve your technical documentations, and also you can decrease your product's time to market faster than ever. So this is one of the customer case study who gets benefit by implementing this technology, Thai Technologies, so who is doing a packaging machinery. So with the help of SolidWork Composer, actually they eliminate a lot of manual reworks, and also they eliminated a lot of times which they are spending in this technical documentations. So after implementing Composer, they said that they cut their documentation time from 40 hours to 5 minutes, and also they saved a lot of customers by identifying their parts with the help of digital parts catalogs, and also they minimized their travel requirements and cost by implementing the service manuals through digitally. So if at all you have any questions and comments related to this specific product, you can feel free to email us through info@egs.co.in. So you can also go through our website to know more about this product. We are also available in Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube. So you can have a look on over to the social sites to know more about us and also as well as this specific product. Thank you.